our objectives, we will identify and illustrate the different kinds of angle pairs, including the supplementary angles, the complementary angles, congruent angles, adjacent angles, linear pair, and vertical angles. So in this video, meron tayong part 2. So sa first part ng ating video, dito po ay i-identify lang po natin at i-illustrate natin kung ano-ano yung kinds of angle pairs. Okay? Sa part 2, doon natin ipapasok yung relationship of geometric figures using measurements and by inductive reasoning. So dito na tayo magsusolve. Okay? So sundan po natin ang second video after po nito. So I have here different kinds of angles. So as you can see, meron tayong iba't ibang klase ng angles. Now I want you to identify the different kinds of angles. So kahit nasa bahay po tayo nanonood, pwede tayong sumubay ng pagsagot dito sa ating activity. So yung green angle natin, this is an acute angle. And then ito, this is a right angle. The next one is acute angle. This one is a right angle. This one is obtuse angle. This is acute angle. This is also acute. And this is also acute angle. Okay. So, very good. Now, marunong na tayo mag-identify ng kinds of angles since na-discuss na to prior dito, bago itong video na to. Now, given these kinds of angles, if we will be combining, kung pagsasamahin natin ang kahit ano dito sa mga angles na to, so if you will be combining any two angles from this set of angles, ayan, okay, so from here, nag-combine tayo ng dalawang angles, nakakabuo tayo ngayon ng angle pairs. Okay, so ano-ano ba itong angle pairs na to? So yung first figure po natin, ito po, this is an illustration of complementary angles and adjacent angles. Now this one, this is an illustration of supplementary angles and adjacent angles, also a linear pair. This one, this is an illustration of supplementary angles, adjacent angles, and a linear pair. And this one, this is an illustration of vertical angles and congruent angles. Now, so ito po yung different kinds of angle pairs. So, iisa-isahin po natin ito. So, let's start. What is an angle pair? So, based nga dun sa nakita ninyong example kanina, kaya siya tinawag na pair because it composed of two angles. So, hindi natin siya pwedeng tawagin na angle pair kung isa lang yung angle mo. So, based dun sa activity natin kanina, nakita ninyo na dalawa ang angles po natin sa bawat angle pair. Okay? So, an angle pair is the relationship that exists between any two angles. So, eto po, binigyan natin ng emphasis na dapat dalawang angles po siya. Okay? Any two angles that can be made as the basis in classifying angles. So, there are different kinds of angles in this manner and they are called angle pairs. So, ang tawag natin dun sa relationship ng any two angles, kapag meron na tayong dalawang angles, ang tawag po natin doon ay angle pair. So, what are those? Una ko nang naipakita kanina, we have the complementary angles, the supplementary angles, adjacent angles, vertical angles. Now, if we will be combining these two, the supplementary and adjacent angles, doon papasok si linear pair. And kapag meron tayong vertical angles, doon papasok si congruent angles. Okay, so therefore, we have six kinds of angle pairs. Namely, the complementary, supplementary, adjacent, vertical, linear pair, and congruent angles.
Sawa ka na sa usual? Mag-Nescafe Creamy Latte. Kakaibang creamy. Caramel, chocolate, at...
Okay. So let's start with the adjacent angles. So iisa-isahin natin ang mga angle pairs natin. So dito, tuturuan ko kayo kung ano ba ang pagkakaiba-iba ng mga angle pairs na to and their relationship. Okay? Ito ba ay related sa ganito? Ito ba ay related sa gantong kinds of sa angle pair na to? So yun po ang aalamin natin. So pag sinabi nating adjacent angles, these are two angles. So again ha, it's always two. Okay? So kung meron kang isang angle lang, hindi po natin siya pwedeng tawagin na angle pairs. Ano-ano yung mga angle pairs? Yung anim na yun. So pag isa lang yung angle, hindi siya belong dun sa angle pairs. Okay? So adjacent angles are two angles with a common vertex, a common side, but no common interior point. So let's have an example. This is an adjacent angle. Ito rin po, and this one. Okay? So these are all adjacent angles. Paano ba natin malalaman na adjacent angles sila? Unang-una, ang sabi dito, dapat meron silang common vertex. So yung dalawang angles mo, as you can see, meron tayong dalawang angles. Ito rin, dalawa. Ito, dalawa. Okay? So yung dalawang angles mo daw, dapat meron siyang common vertex. So as you can see, yung angle 1 mo, ito yung vertex niya. Yung angle 2 mo, ito rin yung vertex niya. Okay? So check tayo dito sa common vertex. Next, common side. So si angle 1, ito po yung side niya. Si angle 2, ito po yung side niya. So ito po yung common side nila. Ganon din po dito at ganon din po dito. So check tayo dito sa common side. But no common interior points. So dapat wala silang interior points, common interior points. So pag sinabi natin interior points, ito po yung interior points ni angle 1. Ito po yung interior points ni angle 2. So as you can see, kanya-kanya sila ng interior points. Okay, this is your angle 1, this is your angle 2. So hindi sila nag-share ng interior points. Okay? So para masabi natin na adjacent angle sila, dapat may common vertex, may common side, pero wala silang common interior points. So that's the time that we can consider the two angles as adjacent angles. Now let me show you an example of two angles na hindi adjacent. Okay, so this is an example of non-adjacent. Ibig sabihin, as you can see, tig-isa sila ng endpoint. So wala silang common vertex. Okay, so wala silang common vertex. So this is not adjacent angles. Another example. So this one is not an adjacent angle. Why? Kasi meron silang common vertex, yes. Pero ito po yung side niya, ni angle 1. Ito naman yung side ni angle 2. So wala silang common side. Okay, so this is not adjacent angles. Another example is this one. So dito wala silang common vertex. Dito wala silang common side. And this one, so ito si angle 1. Ito yung red. Okay, so ito lang po si angle 1. Now si angle 2, ito naman. Okay, ito yung angle 2 mo, itong buo. Kung mapapansin nyo, meron siyang common vertex. Meron din siyang common side. Ano ang common side niya? Ito. Kasi side siya ni angle 1 at the same time, side siya ni angle 2. So check tayo dito sa dalawa. Pero bakit hindi siya adjacent? Because meron silang common interior points. E based dun sa ating definition, there must not be a common interior point. So dapat wala silang common interior. So kagaya nito, si angle 1, ito yung interior niya. Si angle 2, ito yung interior niya. So, naulit siya. Okay? Interior siya ni angle 1 at the same time, interior din siya ni angle 2. Eh, ang sabi, no common interior point. So, that's why this is not adjacent. So, these angles are not adjacent angles. Okay, so let's have the complementary angles. Okay, so pag sinabi natin complementary angles, these are two angles that the sum of the angles should be 90 degrees. So pwede lang nating tawagin na complementary angles sila kapag yung dalawang angles mo, ang sum ng angles nila ay 90 degrees. Okay, let's have an example. So I have here angle ADB and angle BDC. So this is your angle ADB, this is your angle BDC. Now, so as you can see, if we will be adding these two angles, so the measure of angle ADB is 45 degrees and the measure of angle BDC is also 45. So therefore, kung i-add natin sila, the sum is 90. So since 90 ang sum ng dalawang angles mo, therefore, this is an example of complementary angles. Okay? So angle ADB and angle BDC are complementary angles. Okay? Now what if, ma'am, wala po yung measure? Okay, so walang binigay na measure. How will you know that these angles are complementary angles? So paano natin malalaman na ay itong angle na to, itong dalawang angles ay complementary? Okay. So even without the measure, kahit wala siyang measure, pag may nakita kayong symbol na ganito, yung para siyang square, and this is what we call the foot, okay? So kapag may nakita po tayong ganitong symbol, this means that the measure, okay, that the measure of the angle is 90. Okay, so ibig sabihin lang nito na simula dito hanggang dito, ang measure niya ay 90. Yun nga lang, hindi natin alam kung anong measure nito at anong measure nito. Basta ang importante doon, alam natin na kapag inad natin itong measure nito at measure nito, the sum is 90 kasi meron tayong symbol dito. Okay, so ibig sabihin, these two angles measures 90 degrees because of this symbol. Okay, pero hindi tayo pwedeng mag-assume that this is, let's say, 50 degrees, this is 40. Hindi po pwede. Okay, so pwede mo lang ilagay ganito. Okay po. So these two angles are complementary angles. Next, so what if I have this? So ito, isa lang yung binigay. So, if these are complementary angles, so kung ito ay 60, if your angle ADB is equal to 60, then what is the measure of angle BDC? Okay, very good. That is 30. Okay, kung 90 degrees yan at kung ito ay complementary angles, if this is 60, therefore this is 30. Okay, so we will get 90 degrees. So therefore, angle ADB and angle BDC are complementary angles. Now, aside from complementary, i-relate natin ngayon yung previous discussion natin sa previous slide na adjacent angles. We can also call these angles as adjacent angles. Okay? So aside from complementary angles sila, these are also adjacent angles. So, dito na nakikita na natin yung relationship ng angle pairs. Okay? That complementary angles can also be adjacent angles. Next, let me show you an example of complementary angles. Another example, okay? So, these two angles, so si angle A at si angle B are also complementary angles. Why? Because this is angle A is 45 degrees. The measure of angle B is 45. So, therefore, kung 45 ito at 45, 90 yun. Okay? So, this is also an example of complementary angles. Now, this one. Okay, so this is 60 plus 30, so this is 90, so therefore this is also an example of complementary angles. Okay, now so angle A and angle B are complementary angles, but they are not adjacent. Okay, so nare-relate na natin yung isang angle pair kanina, yung adjacent angles. So tatandaan lang na kapag sinabi natin complementary angles, the sum of their measures of two angles is 90 degrees. Yan lang po. Next, let's proceed to the supplementary angles. So kung ang complementary is 90, ang supplementary po is 180. Okay? So tatandaan lang na complementary is 90, supplementary is 180. Let's have an example. So I have here angle ADB and angle BDC. Okay? So, angle ADB plus angle BDC is equal to 180. Why? Because 135 degrees plus 45 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. So, this is the measure of angle ADB. This is the measure of the angle BDC. So, pag inad natin yan, that is 180. Okay? So, pag sinabi natin supplementary, the sum of the two angles is 180. So, this is an example of supplementary angle. So, angle ADB and angle BDC are supplementary angles. Another example. So, I have here angle ADB and angle BDC but different measures. Okay? So, yung angle ADB natin, 70 degrees. Yung angle BDC natin is 110 degrees. Okay? So, if we will try to add this to, the sum is 180. So, since it is 180, therefore, these two are supplementary angles. Okay? So, ganun lang po siya kadali. So, kapag 180 ang sum nila, supplementary angles yun. Okay? So, therefore, we can say that angle ADB and angle BDC are supplementary angles. And, i-relate natin yung previous concept natin kanina. They are also adjacent angles. So, bakit natin nire-relate siya, yung relationship nitong mga angle pairs na to? Kasi mamaya merong tanong na ang supplementary angles ba laging adjacent o ang adjacent angles ba laging supplementary? So, may mga ganung tanong. Kaya dapat dito pa lang, alam nyo na na ito, in this example, supplementary sila at the same time adjacent pa. Okay? Next. So, I have here, okay, another supplementary angle. So, why? Because this is 60, this is 120. So, the angle A is 60 degrees, your angle B is 120 degrees. So, these two are supplementary angles. Okay? But, they are not adjacent angles. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, hindi lahat ng supplementary angles are adjacent. Okay? Pwedeng supplementary sila, pero hindi sila adjacent angles. Okay? Kasi pag sinabi lang naman natin supplementary, the sum must be 180. So, basta 180 siya, supplementary siya. Okay? So, second na lang yung ito, adjacent siya at the same time. Ito, not adjacent. Kasi wala silang common vertex at wala silang common side. Next. Oh, bakit yung ginamit nating example sa supplementary angles ay nandito rin? Okay? How these two related? Anong relationship ng supplementary angle sa linear pair? Kasi yung example ng supplementary angles natin ay ginagamit rin natin dito sa linear pair. Why? So, two angles form a linear pair when they are adjacent and supplementary. Kaya pala, so ibig sabihin, ang linear pair, matatawag natin siyang linear pair o nagfo-form siya ng linear pair kapag adjacent at the same time, supplementary. So, kapag hindi siya adjacent at hindi siya supplementary, ibig sabihin, hindi mo siya pwedeng i-consider na linear pair. Kaya itong dalawa na ginamit natin kanina sa supplementary na example, yun din, ito rin ang nakikita natin dito sa linear pair. Why? Because they are adjacent at the same time, they are supplementary. Okay, and that's the definition of a linear pair. Okay, so therefore, ayun pa rin siya. Now, I have here another example. So, in this example, how will you know that these angles, these two angles are supplementary? Paano natin malalaman? Eh, wala naman siyang measure. Okay, so if angle ADB, so sinabi dito that angle ADB and angle BDC are supplementary, is equal to 180 degrees. So, ibig sabihin, supplementary sila. Pero, how will you know? Eh, wala namang measure. So, kapag minsan, meron tayong ganitong symbol, yung foot, Okay? So, if this is 90, so automatic, this is 90, di ba? Sabi kanina, nabanggit ko na to kanina. So, if this is 90, therefore, yung katabi niya is also 90 degrees. Automatic yan. Kapag yung isa ay 90, automatic, the other one is also 90. So, ayan po siya. So, therefore, this is also a linear pair. Why? Kasi adjacent sila at the same time supplementary. Now, ano pa yung isang dapat tandaan natin para malaman mo na linear pair? Okay, so as you can see, highlighted po yung word na line. Bakit? Kasi pag sinabi nating linear pair, ito yung dalawang angles na makikita mo sa isang line. Okay? So kapag meron kang line dyan at yung dalawang angles mo naglalay, nandoon sa isang line, so kagaya nito, ito yung line, ito yung first angle mo, BDC, ito yung second angle mo, BDA. So kapag yung dalawang angles mo ay nasa isang line, that forms a linear pair. Okay, so dapat nasa isang line sila. So aside from adjacent and supplementary, paano natin malalaman na linear pair? Nasa isang line po sila. Okay? Next, so these are all examples of linear pair. Now I have here, angle A is equal to 60 degrees. Angle B is equal to 120 degrees. So as you can see, the sum of angle A and angle B is 180 degrees. So therefore, it is supplementary. Okay? But, okay, so tingnan natin. Is this a linear pair? No. Why? Because they are just supplementary. Sabi nga sa condition ng linear pair, dapat supplementary and adjacent. So these two are supplementary angles pero hindi sila adjacent. Hindi sila magkatabi, wala silang common side. So ibig sabihin, complementary at supplementary angles lang sila pero hindi sila linear pair. So, ito po yung concept ng linear pair na dapat adjacent at the same time supplementary. Kasi kagaya nito, supplementary angles lang to, pero hindi sila linear pair. Okay? So, dapat alam natin ha, nire-relate na natin lahat ng angle pairs dito. So, dito kasi papasok yung tanong na, are all linear pairs supplementary? Are all supplementary angles form a linear pair? So, kagaya nito, supplementary siya, but it doesn't form a linear pair. So, it's no. Okay? So, dapat alam natin i-analyze yung relationship ng different kinds of angle pairs. Next, let's proceed to the congruent angles. So, pag sinabi natin congruent angles, automatic yan. The measures are equal. Okay? So, yung measure ng dalawang angles na yon dapat equal. So, if the measures of the two angles are equal, okay, kagaya nito. So, I have here angle ADB plus angle BDC, which is equal to 90 degrees. So, as you can see, pareho silang 45 degrees. Okay? So, pag nakita po natin na pareho ng sukat, okay, pareho ng angles, ibig sabihin, they are congruent angles. So therefore, angle ADB and angle BDC are congruent angles. We may write this like this. So this is the symbol for congruency. Okay, so pag sinabi natin congruent, ito po yung symbol niya, yung meron siyang equal, and then meron siyang parang alon sa taas. Okay, kasi we cannot say that they are congruent if they are not equal. So, dapat equal siya para masabi natin congruent. Okay? Yun po ang basehan nun. Okay? So, dapat equal measures so that we can say that these two angles are congruent. By the way, this is the symbol for congruency. Okay? Now, or pwede, you may write this as the measure of angle ADB is equal to the measure of angle BDC. So again, since they are equal, therefore they are congruent. Another example. So since meron tayong symbol na to, kahit walang nilagay na measure dyan, automatic alam natin that this is 90. So if this is 90, therefore this is also 90. Why? Kasi linear pair sila, nasa isang line. So ang linear pair is always supplementary. Pag sinabi natin supplementary, 180. Okay? So since this is, it forms a linear pair, and we have here the symbol, so 90 ito. So therefore, angle WXT plus the measure of the angle TXY is equal to 180 degrees. Kasi they are both 90. So in this figure, in this illustration, we can consider that this is end. It's supposed to be end. Okay, so we have W, angle WXT and WTXY are congruent angles. Okay, so because they are both 90 degrees. Okay, or we can also say that angle WXT is congruent to angle TXY. Why? Because the measure of angle WXT is equal to the measure of angle TXY. So again, we cannot say that they are congruent if they are not equal. So this is the concept of congruent angles. Now, let's have vertical angles. So, you have already the concept of congruent angles. So, let's proceed to the vertical angles. So, vertical angles are formed when two straight lines intersect each other. Okay? So, kapag vertical angles, ito ay binubuo ng dalawang straight lines na nag-i-intersect. So, kagaya po nito. Okay? So, kung meron tayo, kung nag-intersect yung dalawang lines natin, therefore, meron siyang point of intersection. Okay? So, meron siyang point of intersection. Now, isa-isahin natin. Kapag sinabi nating vertical angles, wala po silang common side. Okay? So, wala po silang common side. Kagaya po nito, ito po is vertical to this angle. While this one is also vertical to this angle. So, as you can see, wala po silang common sides. And, paano natin malalaman na vertical angle sila? Yung uncommon side po nila ay opposite rays. Okay? So, mamaya ipapakita natin yan. Okay. So, given this intersection of two lines, nakakabuo po tayo dito ng apat na angles. That's why, from these four angles, nakaka-create tayo ng two pairs of vertical angles. Okay? So, ano-ano ba yung mga vertical angles dito? Angle 1 and angle 3 are vertical angles. Angle 2 and angle 4 are also vertical angles. Okay? So, ulitin ko, wala po silang common side. So, ito yung side ni angle 2. Ito yung side ni angle 4. So, para malaman ninyo na vertical angle sila, wala po silang common side. And, mas madali siyang makakita, tapatan po sila. Okay? So, aside from that, yung uncommon side nila, halimbawa ito, side to ni angle 4, ito side ni angle 2. Yung uncommon side nila ay opposite rays. Ito rin po, side ni angle 4, side ni angle 2, opposite rays po yan. Okay, so yun po yung sinasabi dyan. Yung sides po nila ay opposite rays. Okay, and their angles are non-adjacent. So, hindi yan magkatabi. Tapatan po sila. Okay, so angle 1 and angle 3 as well as angle 2 and angle 4 are vertical angles. Now, if the measure of angle 1 is equal to 115 degrees, okay, if the measure of angle 1 is equal to 115, then the measure of angle 3 is also equal to 115. Why? Because vertical angles are congruent. So, tatandaan po natin na kapag vertical angles, sabi dito, angle 1 and angle 3 are vertical angles. So, kung si angle 1 ay 115 degrees at si angle 3 ay What is the measure of angle 3? That is also 115 degrees. Why? Because vertical angles are congruent. Palagi po yan. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, ito 115 degrees, ito 115 degrees. Reason? Vertical angles are congruent. Now, if the measure of angle 1 is equal to 115, so be given yon na ang measure ng angle 1 is equal to 115, paano natin makukuha yung measure ni angle 2 at ni 4? So, paano natin makukuha yung measure ni angle 2? Okay, pwede mo i-apply yung concept ng linear pair and supplementary angles. Okay. So, tatandaan, kung matatandaan ninyo, si angle 1 at si angle 2, si I supplementary angles. Or, ano sila? Linear pair. So, kung linear pair sila, nasa isang line sila eh. Si angle 1 at si angle 2 nasa isang line. So, linear pair yan. Okay. So, kung linear pair sila, therefore, they are supplementary angles. At pag sinabi nating supplementary angles, the sum must be 180. So, aside from angle 1 and 2, angle 2 and 3 are also supplementary. As well as 3 and 4, and angle 1 and 4 are also supplementary. Now, focus tayo dito kay angle 2. So, since si angle 1 at si angle 2 ay supplementary angles, so ibig sabihin, ang sum nila ay 180. So, ibabawas natin si 180 kay 115. Okay? So, ito yung measure ni angle 1, which is 115. So, measure ni angle 2. Okay? So, the measure of angle 2 is equal to, yun yung hahanapin natin. So, that is 180. Okay? So, ang gagawin po natin, the measure of angle 2 is equal to 180 minus 115. Ima-minus po natin. So, that is equal to 65. So, therefore, this is 65. And the measure of this angle is 65 degrees. Alright, so this is, if the measure of angle 2 is equal to 65, therefore, ano ito? Pwede nyo po i-apply ito. Vertical angles are congruent. So, therefore, this is also 65. Okay? So, ito po yung concept ng vertical angles. Tatandaan that the vertical angles are always congruent.
The blue course moves from point C to point D. If we represent it using a line, we can name it as line CD. Then, the red car moves from point E to point F. If we represent it using a line, we can name it as line EF. If the two cars continue to move in the same direction, do you think the two cars will meet at a certain point? The answer is no. If we represent the movement of the car using a line, the pair of a line that do not meet at any point, even if we extend the line in both directions, is what we called parallel lines. So we can say that line CD is parallel to line EF. We use this symbol to represent parallel lines. Here are some examples of parallel lines. Now, let's again observe the movement of the cars. The blue car moves from point G to point H. If we represent it using a line, we can name it as line GH. Then, the red car moves from point I to point J. If we represent it using a line, we can name it as line IJ. If we represent the movement of a core using a line, we can see that the lines meet at a certain point. This is what we called intersecting lines. So we can say that line GH intersect to line IJ and they meet at point P. Here are some examples of intersecting lines. This time, take a look at the movement of the blue car. It moves from point L to point M. If we represent it using a line, we can name it as line LM. Then, the red car moves from point Q to point R. If we represent it using a line, we can name it as line QR. If we represent the movement of the two cars using a line, we can see that the line intersect at a point. And if we measure the angle of intersection, it measures exactly 90 degrees. A line that intersect and form a 90 degree angle or square corners is what we called perpendicular lines. So we can say that line LM is perpendicular to line QR. We use this symbol to represent perpendicular lines. Here are some examples of perpendicular lines. Let's check your work. Number one is a parallel lines. Number two, perpendicular lines since there are square corners. Number three, it is a intersecting lines. Number four, it is a again, intersecting lines. It is because if we extend the two lines, they will meet at a point. Number five is, again, an intersecting line. So